Otherwise, the magic I perform is in front of the camera. So many people, you know, they pretend to be my father and they've gone down. She's constantly having an emotional, you know, up and down. She's in an emotional roller coaster ride.
One India Film Beat ரசிகர்களே, இன்னைக்கு நம்ம கூட ஒரு அழகான ஒரு பெண்மணி உட்கார்ந்துருக்காங்க. நான் பேசுற தமிழ் அவங்களுக்கு கொஞ்சம் கூட புரியாது, ஏன்னா அவங்களுக்கு தாய்மொழி தமிழா இல்லாட்டியும் அவங்க பண்ணியிருக்கிற அவங்க செலக்ட் பண்ண ஸ்கிரிப்ட் எல்லாம் வந்து ஒரு ஒண்டர்ஃபுல் ஸ்கிரிப்ட் எல்லாம் பண்ணியிருக்காங்க. அதுவும் தமிழ்ல ரெண்டே படம் தான் பண்ணிருக்காங்க, ஜஸ்ட் டூ மூவிஸ் இன் தமிழ். அது வந்து வெர்சடைல் படம். அது இல்லாம அவங்க செலக்ட் பண்ண எல்லா பெங்காலி மூவிஸும் அவ்வளவு பேர் வாங்கி கொடுத்துருக்கு. ஒரு கிரேட் லெஜெண்டுடைய டாட்டர் அப்படிங்கிறதுல நம்ம எல்லாத்துக்குமே பெருமை. இவ்வளவு பில்டப் கொடுக்கறனே யார் இந்த பெண்மணி அப்படிங்கும் போது நீங்களே கண்டுபிடிச்சிருப்பீங்க, சில பேருக்கு தெரிஞ்சிருக்கும். எஸ், த ஒன் அண்ட் ஒன்லி தி கிரேட் மெஜிஷியன், மெஜிஷியன் பி சி சர்க்கார், அதாவது சர்க்கார் சீனியர், சர்க்கார் ஜூனியர், இவங்க வந்து மும்தாஜ் சர்க்கார், ரெண்டு சர்க்கார் கலந்து இவங்க நைன்த் ஜென்ரேஷன் ஆஃப் மெஜிஷியன்ஸ். இன்னும் தே ஆர் டூயிங் த ஒண்டர்ஸ் ஃபார் அவர் சொசைட்டிங்கிறது இன்னும் ஹாப்பியா இருக்கு. வணக்கம் அண்ட் வெல்கம் டு த ஷோ, மும்தாஜ்.
Welcome. I'm so happy to be here with you and everybody, and I'm so excited to do this.
Yeah, I'm very, very glad meeting you, because there are lots and lots of kids all over India, all over the countries. There are fans for your father and grandfather. So Sarkar Senior and Sarkar yes. Junior, they have made magic with a lot of logic. So being a part of that family, how is your feel to be a... How the society is calling you? They call you as Mumtaj or any senior junior name has been added?
Okay, good question. Firstly, I want to explain like a small little thing, which is, so my grandfather, P.C. Sorkar Senior, and then my father, P.C. Sorkar Junior. Now, most of the people now in today's generation and a few generations ahead have watched my father, P.C. Sorkar Junior, perform in Chennai and all around Tamil Nadu. Okay. So, after P.C. Sorkar, in our gharana, in our, you know, the whole legacy, basically, my father was the eighth generation of magician and the ninth generation is us. When I say us, it is like with three sisters. So the first one is Manika, then there is Mobani, and then this is me, Mumtaz.
Wow.
So out of the three...
three Wonder Women.
Out of the three Wonder Women. Oh. And out of the three Wonder Women, the oldest one, Manika, she's the one who's, taking the legacy forward. She's the one representing the, you know, the legacy from our generation. So she's the ninth generation of magician. And very soon, you will see her performing down south and, you know, mesmerizing all. And
we are waiting.
yes, the kind of love that, you know, I have seen my father receive from people down south, it's unimaginable. And, you know, we expect the same or more love from everyone once we go back there with more magic. And when it comes to me, so I don't perform magic like full on stage. I do that at times when we have our family show. That's when my middle sister, who's also an actress in Bengal, and myself, so we perform then. Otherwise, the magic I perform is in front of the camera. I become a different character. Maybe once Lux and maybe once Salima. And then that's the magic I create.
You are doing movie magic.
Yes, absolutely.
Okay.
See, being a magician also, no, you have to be an actor. A magician, when my father is performing, you know, he's enacting the role of a magician. So he has to be a strong actor as well to, you know, create that... aura, to create that situation. So that is there. And one more thing which I would like to tell all the viewers, your amazing viewers, is there was P.C. Sorkar Senior, there was P.C. Sorkar Junior, there is P.C. Sorkar Junior, there is no P.C. Sorkar da-da-da-da, no micro, mini, mini-tip, minuscule, capsule, dot, full stop, no.
Nothing.
You know, after P.C. Sorkar Junior comes Manika Sorkar from the Sorkar legacy.
Okay, understood. So no more scams or no more rumors. It's all the names which we pronounce exactly.
Yeah, because, you know, there's so many people, you know, they pretend to be my father and they've gone down. They've gone to Chennai, they've gone to different parts of Tamil Nadu and they've like performed there. And you know what? It hurts. It we feel sad to see how they misuse the name which that had to be created after so much of hard work and everything. And you know, people expect a certain level of performance. They know when it is a Sorkar, when it is PC Sorkar, it's the ultimate. He's like the living legend. So when you're watching a legend's performance in show, you know, you expect great things. And then there are like weird people who just come, use the name, and they fool people saying that this is the Sorkar. And when people go to watch the show and they realize, oh my God, this is not the same guy. So, yes. You know, that is really bad.
Yeah. Always original, so is original, and original has the best value for it.
Exactly. And the original has three daughters. Three girls.
Three girls. Yeah. 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 We are waiting for all the performance from the three Wonder Women. And you are doing wonders in the movie industry, particularly a lot of Bengali movies. And Irvi Chutre is one movie which we can't forget, which we cannot even mention each and every dialogue. So the many scenes are there. Particularly, you have done a sister role, was amazing role. Only thing is that the face of the character, the costume of the character, the dusky feel, it is a great changeover. And people, when you meet you, this is Sarkar, this is Mumtaz. They totally confused.
See, magic.
Yes. Irvi Chutre, overall Irvi Chutre, when you rewind and see the movie, what comes to your mind, what you want to say, tell the audience?
I think firstly, I am so grateful to Sudha, my director, obviously, for giving me the opportunity to, you know, be a part of Irvi Chutre. The whole project was so near and dear, and especially that was my first Tamil film, and not only my first Tamil film, it was my first bilingual film. So it was Hindi and Tamil. Yes. And
Salagadu was also a great hit.
Yes, yes. So I was just so happy to be part of a project like that. And you know, more than anything, what I truly loved was the story. It was such a beautiful story. The way Sudha had, you know, visualized the whole thing, the way she had that, you know, in front of her. It was something that I could not, like, I had to be a part of it. And so the whole thing, and when it comes to my character's name was Lux over there. So I found Lux's character so challenging because she has so many, you know, grafts, so many layers into her. She's not only this, you know, just a normal fighter. She's not only somebody who, you know, who fights or who screams or shouts. No, she's constantly having an emotional, you know, up and down. She's an emotional roller coaster ride. So to, you know, get into each layer of her character, that was a challenge, and the challenge is what I seek. That is what excites me in a role.
The so punches you gave, it. The way you gave the poses and all, it was really nice. And when we finish the school, college,
and you know, of course, Madhavan sir, I mean, oh my God, it was like.
Yeah, that was only I was trying to ask. When we finished the school, college and all, no?
That was like amazing.
Yeah, we'll be connected with WhatsApp groups and everything. We connect with friends, no? Like that, Irvi Chutre, do you people have a WhatsApp group separately, connecting Ritika, connecting Madhavan sir, or do you people stay connected often?
We honestly, while we were shooting and the initial few days and months, we did. But now, obviously, we all have, you know, gotten involved with our own lives and everything. But it is true that we do stay connected once in a while. And we've all become such great friends, you know. So when you're good friends, you don't have to keep in touch every day. But suddenly come back, you pick it up from where you left it, you know. So you'll be like, hey, what's up? And just continue with the flow. So, but amazing people. And it has been an amazing experience.
Super, super, Mumtaz. The energy what you have, the way you talk, the way you tell about the people whom you carried in the cinema industry, it's all really, really great. And when we talk about Irvi Chutre, Madhavan sir, Ritika, Sudha, all apart, you are done boxing, really practiced boxing in Calcutta, finishing your LLB in Calcutta. Yes. You have done a lot of magic in your hometown. And we are very proud that you people are from the city where Satyajit Ray was born, the god of cinema. He has made a lot of wonderful movies, and you people are from that particular city.
Thank you. Honestly speaking, you know, for me, the way I look at it, I'm very proud to be a Bengali. I'm very proud that I come from West Bengal. But at the end of the day, you know, I'm a true artist, and an artist can be anywhere. He or she can come from anywhere. You know, yes. The art comes from within. So I nurture that more than, put myself in a particular region or anything. The reason why, a lot of people here in Bengal tell me that Mumtaz, you're not only doing Bengali cinema, but you're doing cinemas in different languages. Yes. And that's what I tell them, that the language is no barrier. At the end of the day, we're all human beings. We have the same emotions. You know, if I get hurt, it'll hurt me. It'll hurt you. If I cut myself, I'll bleed. If you cut yourself, you will bleed. So at the end of the day, we're all the same. So it is the love, it is the respect, it is humanity at the end of the day, which is most important. And we should always, always highlight that.
Okay. Whenever you come to Chennai, what connects you a lot? What kind of places you often visit in Chennai? What is your favorite place in Chennai?